हाँ हेलो, माय नेम इज उमेश शर्मा। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टुवर्ड्स ओनर्स। हियर ओनर्स कंट्रीब्यूट कैपिटल टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिकॉज दे आर टेकिंग सो मच ऑफ रिस्क इन मेकिंग इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द बिजनेस एंड दिस शुड बी एडिक्वेटली रिकग्नाइज्ड। ये शेयर होल्डर्स इज नथिंग बट ए शेयर इन द शेयर कैपिटल ऑफ ए कंपनी। शेयर होल्डर इज नथिंग बट हु कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स कैपिटल टू द ऑर्गनाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड शेयर होल्डर्स। अरे यार ऑर्गनाइजेशन के कैपिटल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स मातारो और ना शेयर होल्डर्स अंत करती। शेयर होल्डर्स आर दि ओनर्स आफ् दि कंपनी। शेयर होल्डर्स मे बी आफ् प्रिफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स आर दि इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स। हियर इट इज डिस्कस्ड इन फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग आर दि कॉर्पोरेट अकाउंटिंग दैट इज प्रिफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स आर दि प्रिफरेंशियल राइट ओवर डिविडेंड एज वेल एज दि रीपेमेंट आफ् कैपिटल। इन द केस आफ् इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स दे आर हैविंग दैट इज दे आर नॉट हैविंग preferential right over dividend as well as repayment of capital. These are main two types of shares and the who contributes capital to the organization are called shareholders of the company. The primary business of business is to stay in business because each and every company thinks that they should be in the particular line of business. How to stay in the particular line of business? For staying in the particular line of business, company is supposed to earn profits. And how they are earning profits and at the same time, they should be distributed to shareholders in the form of dividend because they are making, owners are making investment in the company and at the same time, they are expecting financial returns. What they are investing, that is in the form of dividend. Dividend refers to portion of the profit distributed to shareholders because why they are investing, that is at the time of investment they think that they should get something in return. How they are getting return, how much they are getting return, that is the shareholders. The shareholders thinks that they are expecting from the company. That is, while distributing dividend, the company should earn profit. That is, how the companies are distributing profits, whether they are adequate reserves should be built up so that it will be able to declare a reasonable dividend. That is, there are different types of dividend policies are there. Scrip dividend is there. Cash dividend is there, stock dividend is there. There are different types of dividend policies are there. That is how those policies are framed by the organization to safeguard the interest of the shareholders. Because in the dynamic world, the change is taken place. That is how the position of the particular shareholders is safeguarded. That is, they should safeguard the interest of the shareholders and at the same time whatever the investment made by the shareholders that should be safe in the hands of the company because the shareholder simply contributes capital to the organization and the workers are working in the organization, managers are managing the organization. Here in the case of the companies, owners are different, workers are different, managers are different. But whatever the capital contributed by the shareholders, that should be safe and they should get adequate returns. The main aim of organization is that is profit maximization and wealth maximization. Profit maximization is nothing but every organization expects they should earn maximum profits. Because if they earn profits, companies are able to provide sufficient or adequate salaries, benefits to the employees, And if they are earning profits, companies paying taxes to the government, and they are able to take other activities, that's only the criteria of the business is to earn profit. But while earning profit, companies should not indulge in any harmful activities either to the society or to the employees or to the competitors or to the suppliers or to, that is, who are the stakeholders of the company. Those stakeholders should not get suppressed. That is, they should have positive impact on the organization, because if they earn profit, companies able to survive in the particular line of business. But how to survive in the particular line of business? By following the, that is, whatever the norms framed by the either the local government or the state government or the central government. The main aim of business is to earn profit, but while earning profit, they are not supposed to indulge in any, that is, harmful activities. And wealth maximization. Wealth maximization is nothing but, that is, in terms of benefit, that is, whatever the wealth of the shareholders, that should grow. That is, not in short term, that should be in long term. That is, in the case of the companies, that is, in the case of, especially in the case of the shareholders, they are thinking that they should invest for the long periods, not for the short periods. For that reason, how to, that is, long term survival of the particular business, how to survive in the long run. That is, the company should provide quality products and services, they should maintain employees properly, and they should retain the talented employees. If they retain the talented employees, that will give maximum return to the organization. At the same time, shareholders should satisfy, because whatever the profit made by the company, that should be properly distributed, adequate reserve should be maintained. If it is something happen in future, company should be in a position to survive. And next is, the shareholders are interested not only in the protection of their investment and the return on it, but also in the image of the company. Shareholders are expecting, that is, return, and at the same time, safety of the particular investment, and also the, that is, what is the image on the company, that is, in the public, what the people are thinking regarding the particular company, whether the particular company is having positive impact or not. That is, what are the activities done by the particular organization? Government is also monitoring, for example, in the case of the capital, SEBI is monitoring in the case of financial activities, even Reserve Bank of India is also monitoring, income tax authorities, sales tax authorities, that is, all the government, registrar of companies, department of company affairs, all the departments are the, all the, that is, statutes of the governments are, that is, managing and at the same time monitoring the activities of the company. And companies should not indulge in any negative activities, and they should safeguard the public image in terms of the particular shareholders. And companies should go by increasing the value of shares, that is, how the value of shares is increased. Because if you see in the share markets, that is, how the value of the share is fluctuating. If the companies are earning profits, the value of shares increases. If the company is not earning profits, at that time, value of the share decreases. Even if something happened, that is, any negative activities in the particular company, automatically the value of the share decreases. If the value of share decreases, automatically the shareholders lose their, even the return as well as their capital. For that reason, companies always think they should increase the value of shares, that is, how the, what are the activities taken care by the organization to increase the value of shares. And they should run the business efficiently, that is, how the business is running, whether the particular business is running efficiently or not. that is whether they are the particular company utilizing the resources properly or not. That is adequate, that is resources are there, at the same time they should use efficiently. If they use efficiently, that is automatically that will return more. For example, in the case of the working capital or the long-term capital, if they simply produce goods and if it is only in the godown, that will not fetch any return to the organization. That is, the capital is blocked in inventory, and for that portion, company is not earning any profit. For that reason, they should manage the particular company efficiently. And whatever the information regarding the company, that should be properly communicated to shareholders, because shareholders every day thinks that is they are investing in the particular company, and at the same time whatever the investment made by the shareholders, they should be safe and secure, and they should get proper return. Because in the case of the share market, if something happened, automatically the shareholders lose their capital, because it is hard earned money, they should not lose. These are some of the activities. These are the main responsibilities of the company. That is, main thing is relating to profit maximization and wealth maximization. That is, how the companies are earning profit and how the wealth of the shareholders is increasing. That is, while earning profit, company should not indulge in any negative activities. Thank you. This is regarding the responsibilities of a company towards owners of the company, that is shareholders. Thank you.